Happy Sunday morning, YouTubers. You know what time it is. It's that time again. Model cars and coffee time. And today we've got another good one here. This is a topic that I talked about a couple weeks ago. These kits that you start and put back on the shelf. So your abandons, your zombie kits, there's all kinds of terminology that people are using for them. In my case, it's probably just a case of ADD or just getting sidetracked. Or at this time, I think this is another one of those kits that I started with good intentions. And you're at that age where you're just wanting to drive cars, real cars. You got your license now. You're focused on your one-to-one stuff. I mean, that's as a teenage kid, that's what you do. So this is another one that goes way back. And I thought about it the other day because of a couple of the components that come in this kit, which I will show you. And I thought, you know what? I need to look for that. And that'd be a nice piece to have in a diorama. So with no further ado, let's hear a quick little commercial here from our sponsor. And then we will get right into this zombie kit. Be right back. We're back. It's great to have Gallery back on the channel again this year. That means a lot to me. They're a great company. Let's get these are drill bits, if anybody's wondering what that is. This is the way I buy my drill bits. So I gotta restock my cabinet out in the big shop. Those came in yesterday too. So this here is my other zombie kit. I enjoy the heck out of this kit. I built one a long time ago, and then I don't remember what happened to it. If I gave it away as a present, something like that. That's what seems to ring the bells. I built the first one and gave it away. So I don't know what happened to it. And this was the second one because I bought two of these back in the day. Let me see here. What year was this thing? Yeah. It says here, let's see here. Yep, 1992. So I know I bought two of these. This is the only one I've got left. So the big thing that was cool with this kit was, for one, this was during the Pro Street time in the one-to-one. I mean, Pro Street in your car was everything back then. So this kit came with the famous Mickey Thompson Sportsman tires that everybody was Pro Street in their one-to-ones with. And then this kit was tub, which the 68 Roadrunner that came out before this was also tub, but it had some really cheesy tires on the back of that kit. Was not impressed with AMT on the choice of that, but you know, I get it nowadays. I understand it. Back then when I was younger, I didn't understand that, you know, you had to pay for production rights and stuff to utilize, you know, the Mickey Thompson name and to copy their stuff. So the other thing that was really cool with this kit is this here. If you're a Mopar guy, I know that Chrysler had dabbled around back in the days with all kinds of different prototype development engines and stuff for racing. And I don't know why AMT decided to do this, but I'm very glad that they did, was that Chrysler did produce a dual overhead cam Hemi as a prototype development piece to basically test. This thing never went into production, but this kit comes with, you know, a standard Hemi like the Roadrunner did, the 68 AMT Roadrunner, and this prototype dual overhead cam version too. So you could build it one of two ways. So I thought, well, that's kind of cool. And that's where I thought about this kit the other day. And I thought, yeah, that thing had that that dual overhead cam deal. So here it was something that I was going to do for myself. I believe I was going to paint this thing green, because I'll show you why here in a minute. I think what I'm going to do is even putz with this thing today. Let's see here. This thing is really kind of cool for being a pro street deal. So if you see here, my centerline wheels, I've already, I started to highlight them green with some candy color in them back then. So the body still hasn't, it's still got all its ugly mold lines and things like that. But it's a neat chassis to start with. It's pretty detailed. Here's that dual overhead cam Hemi that I started back then. I think part of me wants to keep this out, detail it a little bit more, and maybe put it in on an engine stand. But I think I might just put it in this thing. All the other parts are still in this box to produce the other Hemi, other than the block and the transmission. You basically had to choose what heads you were going to use. Hang on one second. Sorry about that. I had to shut that furnace off. It was just kicking on, and I'm like right below it here. So, but yeah, this is going to be kind of neat. Maybe I will just kind of detail that motor out some more and then leave it in this Cornet. I really kind of would like to get this thing done. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to definitely look at creating some sort of a group build. I talked about it before on my channel. I know it's been brought up on the AMC show as well. Something to get these zombie kits done. I think that'd be a lot of fun. A lot of these kits I think people have that are at a good starting point to where you could easily finish them. So it wouldn't be like a normal group build where you're starting from scratch. You just kind of taking the thing and running it home down the finish line. So I think that's something that we're going to do sometime here, probably after Christmas. I will announce something, and we will definitely get some of these builds done. This is going to be a lot of fun. There you go. You can see the nice iconic Mickey Thompson tread pattern. That, I mean, this thing came with, to me, some of the best pro street tires, especially back in the day, but I would still say till to this day to use. So very cool. I love this kit. I definitely want to try and buy some more of these kits to have in my stash, and then maybe do something a little different with it too. So very cool. I love this kit. I should have kept the first one that I built, and I didn't. But you know, it is what it is. Like I said, I don't remember what happened to it. I will say this too, is even my wife, back when we first met, we would build models together. She's got her own little stash. It was always something. Even I do remember the prior girlfriend too built a couple models with me. So it's definitely something that I've always done, is modeling. Just kind of came and gone. But who knows, maybe my previous girlfriend's got the other one. It's probably in the garbage. Don't know, but I can't imagine who else I would have gave it to. But I do remember I had two of these. I built one, and then this one here was going to be one that would sit on my shelf. So definitely want to work on that. I'm glad I dug this thing out. There's the windows and the rest of the chrome stuff. So oh, it's even got the air grabber for like the Roadrunner too in this kit, which I'm sure a lot of the stuff was very similar to the AMT 68 Roadrunner deal. Yeah, pretty much is. Those wheels definitely are. Yep. No, this is gonna be a lot of fun. A lot of fun. Like I said, this was 92 when I was playing with these things. You can see that we got to address some stuff. You don't sit very level. So yeah, this will be a lot of fun to redo that. So anyhow, let's flip this around. There you have it. Another great kit. This was never my favorite body style for B-body cars, but when you Pro Street anything, they look beautiful. So, and there's something about that lime green that stood out at you. Even though I've always been a black and then a blue guy, really, those are my two favorite colors. I like purples a lot too. But this lime green on this big ass Coronet, just cool. The box art just really drew me in. But like I said, and I'm surprised that I didn't buy more of these back in the day because of the tires. And that was the thing, like my 70 GTX, my monogram kit that I've shared on this Model Cars and Coffee before too. I was back halfing these kits, you know, as a teenager. I was taking the drag car kits and whatnot and back halfing them. The thing was, is you're pretty much bound to the slicks, whether you're using a Mean and Nasty Camaro, a Bob Glidden Thunderbird kit. I'm trying to think, there was a few different ones. There was a Chief, Bob Glidden Chief kit, the Frank Iaconi kit. There was a few kits back in the day, well before the pro mods of the Soft Seal, the Christine, the Charles Carpenter, and then the Jukebox Ford. There was other kits that were out prior to that, that you were great candidates to kit bash and take the back tires. But there again, you were all slicks. Until this kit here came out, you didn't have those big fat Mickey Thompsons. Not to my knowledge anyhow. So I'm surprised I didn't buy more of these. I only bought two. And I built one, gave it away, and this is the last remainder. So definitely going to be something that I'll have to search for at shows to see if I can't find a couple more of those kits to purchase. So that's going to do it for today. Another short video. I'm trying to refine my stuff. I'm trying to make this stuff more enjoyable to watch and not me just rambling. There are a couple other videos that I have made that are... got a lot more detail and rambling. I don't know how well they're going to do. They are RC related. And I'm probably going to edit them a little bit and try. Because I'm definitely trying very hard to learn how to do this stuff better for you, the viewer. Like I said, I appreciate everybody. Thanks for all the subscribers. We've gained about another 10 subscribers. That's truly awesome. I'm very appreciative of that. And make sure you smash that like button, give me a thumbs up, give me a thumbs down, whatever floats your boat. And leave me a comment. I enjoy all the comments. A lot of great people that I've met since starting this YouTube thing. Really, really having a lot of fun. So that's going to be it for me today. Have a great rest of your Sunday. I got a lot of chores and stuff to do around here, and we got to get some errands done before Thanksgiving week comes. So have a great day, everybody. Goodbye.